It's a big game for the club on Saturday night. I think everybody's working really hard to get back up the table as much as they can. The lads have been working really hard on the training pitch the last number of weeks. Unfortunately, we had a bit of a setback against Bray, but I think at times the performance is very good. Remember, as a supporter, games against Galway United are always entertaining. There's always a good atmosphere. The fans always come out and support us against teams such as Galway, Finn Harps. And I think on Saturday night, I think the lads are going to be confident after a good week's training. They put in a really hard, tough week with double sessions. And I think they're well prepared now. Everybody's working hard towards the game on Saturday, and the boys will hopefully get the result that we need. Darren Kelly, man, no stranger to a Connacht Derby. How are your feelings towards the game on Saturday night?
Yeah, well, it's going to be hopefully an exciting occasion for our fans to come out and support us. You know, Connacht Derbies were major back in the 90s and noughties, you know, and it's a great opportunity for the Connacht fans to come and see them again. Obviously, hopefully on Saturday night we'll bring a good crowd and good support to the showgrounds. I remember the crowds a few years ago, you know, sometimes the crowds excite the players and vice versa, the players excite the fans. We need to be in this together to push the club forward.
Brian McMorrow, strength and conditioning coach for Sligo Rovers. You've had a big role in preparing the team for Saturday night's game against Galway United. How do you feel they're looking?
Yeah, they're looking really good. We've had a really good week's training. Monday, we're still recovering from the game on Saturday. Obviously, some of the boys were down after a bad result. So we took Monday to try and lift them back up again and finish off a recovery. Tuesday, we had a really good session, really tough session in the morning, did some conditioning. And then sort of working some tactics later on with Joe. But strength and condition wise, they're definitely improving every week. Putting a lot of work in, and hopefully we'll see the benefits on Saturday.
Do you feel there's any pressure on you, whether the lads perform or not on the night?
I think the guys have put in a really good week's training. I hope they're in a lot better condition now than they were maybe a few weeks ago. We're working on it every week. I think we're going to see the benefits on Saturday. I'm looking forward to the game. Really looking forward.
That's two of the more important men in the showgrounds. It's your job to get the whole place ready for the big game on Saturday. Has it been a busy week for you?
Well, yes, pretty busy. As usual, we know what we have to do before each game, how to prepare for it.
It's obviously a big game on the pitch as well. How do you see the result going?
Well, hopefully we're confident of picking up 3 points as we look at it.
On top of that, we're here every day and we see the way the boys are working, and they should be getting a lot more points out of it because they are working very hard.
David Cawley, club captain, a disappointing result against Bray on Saturday night. How important is it that we bounce back at home to Galway United this Saturday in the showgrounds?
It's real important, you know, it's a big game. Galway aren't a bad side and we're looking to kick on, you know, and it's a Connacht Derby as well. It's my first one at the showgrounds actually, and I'm really, really looking forward to it, and I'm hoping for a decent atmosphere as well.
Obviously they were at the wrong end of the table at the moment, some were not used to being. Do you think you've more responsibility as the captain to maybe bring the squad together and get a result in every game and get us back up towards the top end of the league?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. It's a little bit more responsibility, but again, you know, whatever 11's out on the pitch, I think, you know, we've all got to be leaders in our own way. Whether it be the way you play or vocally or whichever way it is, but I think the 11 that are selected need to all work together and work hard to get us back up that table where we should be.
Obviously with the added spice of being a Connacht Derby, you'd hope the fans come out and support the lads on Saturday night?
Yeah, it's a big game, you know. Crowd was good against Dundalk, so hopefully they come out, a few more come out and support us, you know. I think we upped it against Dundalk, I think we played well, we were unfortunate to lose, but you know, hopefully another two home games on the bounce now with the Connacht game coming up, and hopefully we can go out and win. it's a massive game for us. We know we have to get out of the position we're in, but I think we're good enough to move forward and get a good run of games going. Everybody's working in the right direction anyway.
Raf, after a disappointing result against Bray, how preparations for the Connacht Derby been this week in training?
Training's been very good. It's been tough. We've had double sessions all week, and we're preparing right anyway. So that's the main thing. So we're looking to go in and get a positive result out of it and bounce back from the Bray defeat, should I say.
Raf, obviously Connacht Derby on Saturday adds to the importance of the game. It's important that the fans come out and support you on Saturday night and give you all the encouragement you need.
Absolutely. Obviously if there's a full house there or the support is there, it's like a 12th man. So, it's vitally important that we get the crowds in to cheer us on. And again, as I said, be nice and positive with everything that we do and what we're gearing up to do. So, yeah, it's going to be an interesting tie. We know what Galway are about. It's not going to be easy. So, as I said, we've been working really hard all week and we're looking forward to the game on Saturday. So, yeah, 3 points is a must.
Richard Brush, as you can see, best looking, best dressed man in the league. Have you had a tough week preparing for the game on Saturday against Galway?
Tough week. Every week's a tough week now. We're trying hard. Got to get 3 points on the board.
Disappointing setback against Bray Wanderers, but we'll always be looking to kick on now and get 6 points in the next two home games. Obviously, a Connacht Derby Saturday, you'll be hoping the crowd come out and support you.
Obviously not. Connacht Derby's always been a big turnout on a whole. So if we get the crowd behind us, it's an extra man for us. Definitely get 3 points then.
Yeah, what's going on here?
Well, we have the boys here getting a wee flush. In the hamstrings. This is Jake Dykes. Hello, Jake.
Say what?
Hi. Can't believe you're up in the bed again.
Never leaves the bed.
Hey!
Huh?
Yeah, we got a
roll. This is Captain
David Colley. Oh, we've had the word already. And we've
seen
the
word already, yeah.
He's
Steve. Jake, what's going on? You alright?
I don't know, ask me, Phil.
You're not in
getting
the
bed? Flush. No, it's getting a flush out. Bit of tight now. Working hard.
Recovery for you.
Yeah.
Been a tough week, have you?
Yeah, been a tough week, yeah.
All building up for the game on Saturday?
Yeah. Just looking forward to it now. Only got 3 points.
Rich, how are we looking on the injury front?
Looking good.
All good?
All good. Legs is looking good. Who else is out? Kev's ankle.
He's struggling, just a doubt.
He should be back by the end of the week.
Right.
And John Ross is improving big time.
Stuff.
And that's it, really. Other than that, we're looking good.
Happy enough. So you're enjoying your first season in the job, yeah?
Loving it.
Loving it?
Yeah. It's a great one.
You have it handy, really, you know?
I do, all right. I wish.
What do you think about the big game on Saturday? Connacht Derby, Gola. Your first Connacht Derby to be involved in, obviously.
Should be a big crowd,
yeah. Hopefully
you beat them and then go on to
Longford. Do you get nervous now running on the pitch at all? You're over that.
I'm over that stage.
Yeah.
At the beginning, maybe. Not anymore.
Good stuff.
Are
you nearly finished now for the day?
Nearly finished. 2 o'clock, probably.
2 o'clock,
and then I'm out of here.
So, this is the kit room in the club. A room which many of you probably haven't seen or probably even know it exists. But this is basically where we get all the gear ready for every game and the training sessions. And we have, here's your kit for Saturday night. We obviously in our home kit. There's Rory Keating back from his loan spell at Finn Harps. We just got that jersey in today. There's a jersey with a new sponsor, PhD. Another big new sponsor on board. There's the away kit. Bring you over here, there's the match shorts. There must have 20-25 pairs a game just to have them in case anything goes wrong. Over here, see all the warm-up tops, all the warm-up t-shirts, Under Armours, there's your red ones for your home games, blue ones, whenever we're playing away, and we need to use the blue kit, jackets, probably won't need those with the weather we've been having the last couple of weeks, and there's match balls, we've 8 of those to give those to the referees. Before the game, they'll check them all out for pressure, for size, and they'll be the balls being used in the game. This is basically a bit of everything over here. There's your match socks, your keeper socks, then you have all your accessories in here. Speakers, that's important. So you can play a bit of music for the lads to relax. Stuff like shin guards, loads of them there. You have undershorts, true socks. There's a hat for keeper, you might need that Saturday night, you never know. Come over here, all that is really is some spare gear. And there's under 19s and under 17s gear, which we'll be putting back into use now in the next few weeks, of course. But everything's ready really for the game on Saturday. All you have to do is put it up now on Saturday. It's a couple of days before the game, so we have it all ready. It's just now to do the final bits and pieces for the game and prepare now. And hopefully we'll get a positive result after it all. Frank Byrne, a man who you'll always see in and around the showgrounds, helping everyone out. What's the feeling been like around the place in the last few days in the build-up to the game against Galway United on Saturday here?
Well, despite the negativity that has gone on before this, Colin, I haven't seen any of it at all. I've enjoyed seeing you all coming in so happy every day. Believe it or not, the public wouldn't believe that, but that's what is going on. And the last 25 years, it's just as good, the positivity that is going on. So, it'll turn. I'm quite convinced it will. I've seen times like this before, so it's nothing. It's okay. Everybody will get negative about things from time to time. It's football. No footballer goes out to play a bad game. So I'm too old now to tug out, but
we might do it if you're around on Saturday night.
Oh, I could be. You'd never know.
Bring a pair of shorts and socks for you.
Well, if you fix me up, Colin, I might be on the bench.
We'll see what we can do, Frank.
Thanks.
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. And may you stay forever young. May you stay forever young. May you grow up to be righteous. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. May you always be courageous. Stand upright and be strong. And may you stay forever young. May you stay forever young. May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of change shift. And may your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung. And may you stay forever young. May you stay.